150-yard bomb play every game. Shepard is good. Beckham is Beckham. They got Will Tye involved now over Larry Donnell, and it's paying off. They got Paul Perkins playing at running back, to spell Jennings once in a while. That was a nice little scramble by me. And now Shane Vereen's coming back soon. I don't think Shane Vereen's gonna be back this week, but I think he's gonna be back for the Dallas game. And I think their offensive luck, they'll be getting a couple of their offensive linemen back too, so they're gonna be getting healthy at the right time. So then on the flip side of that, you got the Steelers. The Steelers are fighting for their playoff lives, but they're just not that good this year. Roethlisberger's going to be Roethlisberger. You can't say anything bad about him. I love Roethlisberger. You can have nine guys hanging all over him, and he's still going to throw a bomb for a touchdown. Antonio Brown is as dangerous as anybody in football. Easily. Top. You can make the argument that he's number one receiver in football. No one would tell you you're wrong. Same with Beckham. No one would tell you you're wrong. There's a few guys like that where you can't argue one way or the other who's better because they're just that good. Le'Veon Bell is good. Where I think the Giants have the advantage is their offense against the Steelers' defense. That's where I think this game comes down to. I think it's the Steelers' offense against the Giants' defense. I think the Giants' defense has an edge that way. And I think the Giants' offense has an edge over the Steelers' defense. I understand. I'm not saying this because I'm a Giants fan. I'm trying to be objective about this. But I just think that the Giants have too much momentum right now. And if things go the way they should, they're setting up for a huge, huge showdown against Dallas. And I think they're going to beat Dallas. I really do. They beat them the first game of the year. I understand. It was their first game, and Prescott was still, learning the way, and Elliott was just getting started and all that. But I just think the Giants are going to beat him. I don't know why. I just think that the Giants have something going this year. I know Dallas does too. They definitely do. It's definitely going to make for a bunch of interesting games down the line, I can tell you that. But let's get through this week first. I think that the Giants just are better all around than the Steelers. I think their special teams is better. I thought I was going to pick that. Instead, I got mossed by Moss. That's annoying. The guy takes all these dumpy little routes all game. Now all of a sudden he's going to face catch me. Like, that's annoying. I mean, look, he's got 11 completions for 130 yards. The reason I point that out is because, generally speaking, if I had 11 completions, I'd have probably 200 yards. Oh my God. I thought that was going to be a pick. We're definitely getting some BS right now. I still think I'm going to stop this guy. I do. He's going to do something. He's going to make a mistake somehow. But in the meantime, I just got to keep going score for score. I just think that the Steelers are a better team. I'm sorry. I think the Giants are a better team than the Steelers all around. Their special teams is better. They've blocked a couple of field goals this year. They're going to have Beckham returning punts most likely. That's a little dodgy to me. I know the Steelers do it with Antonio Brown. Give me that. I know the Steelers do it with Antonio Brown, and the Cardinals used to do it with Patrick Peterson. That worries me a little bit. I know you saw the game last week against the Browns. He had huge returns, one for a touchdown that got called back on a call that shouldn't have even been a penalty. But I'm not going to get into that again with the referees and all that nonsense. They got to figure that out somehow in the offseason. You know what they should do? Just make it simple. If there's a questionable call, make it challengeable. I know that slows the game down, and I know it's a pain in the ass, but You got to figure this out because too many games are being decided now by blown calls. It's really just not right. Now, let's say for argument's sake, I understand it's the Browns. All right. Now, I contradicted what I said before about my passing game, too. I knocked this guy for having 130 yards for 11 completions. I have the same amount of completions. I only have 30 yards more. But it's not for lack of trying. I am trying to go deep. But I got to be careful, too. That's dodgy. You just gotta be careful. But yeah, so I think the Giants are just a better all around team right now. I'm picking the Giants to win that game. I'm sorry it took me so long to get through all that. I really wanted to focus on them because I haven't posted in a long time, so I haven't really been able to do my picks. And the NFC East is definitely shaping up for a really, really tight race to right to the end of the season too. And barring some kind of phenomenal collapse, you have to say that right now, Dallas, the Giants, and the Redskins are probably all going to make the playoffs. Two wild cards and then a division winner. That's pretty fucking hardcore, man. For three teams to come out of one division to make the playoffs. But this year it could definitely happen. What's killing me right now is I would love it if the Giants played the Packers and the Vikings now. They had to play them when they were freaking hot and they were good. And they, you know, it's just always the way it goes. And they had no business losing that Redskins game. They're up 21-9 and they lost. And that just makes me sick. But either way, it's just a lot of great games, man. And it's coming down to the wire. That's why you gotta love the NFL. They make these schedules, man, and they put it in such good playoff position. So that the division, you know, division games at the end of the year matter the most. Now we're in a little bit of a scenario here. Is this guy... I got to figure out how to stop him now. That sack that I took was bad because that knocked me out of any scoring chance I had. So now I got to figure out a way to stop this guy. He's got these underneath routes. And you can go two ways here. You can either play for the tie and force overtime, or you go for the kill shot and try and win. We'll see what his first play is like. He's got Moss out wide to the right. If he tries to Moss me, we'll know right away if he's going for the win or not. Nope. That's conservative. So maybe he's going to try and play for a field goal. Unless he's going to save the Moss play for when he needs it. I don't know. This is definitely dodgy. He's got two guys he can go deep to. He's got Gronkowski and he's got Moss. Oh, finally got the interception. I was waiting for that. I told you. I said at some point he's going to make a mistake. And that was it. I got to put this game away now, though. I got to get this. I got to score here. A touchdown. No field goal bullshit. Just put this game away. Oh, my God. I just threw it right back to him. That fucking sucks. So much for putting this game away. Only thing I did is give him more room to throw it to Moss. God damn it. Yeah, see, now he's trying to go to Moss hardcore now. Fuck, man. I can't believe I did that. I gotta stop him here. I wonder what this guy would do if I stopped him here, if he would go for it or not. If he does, I mean, he's basically giving me the game. Oh, God damn it. I was there too. I went the wrong freaking way. You know, he's got me so preoccupied with Moss right now. That's fucking nonsense. But that'll showboat, dude. There's fucking still 2 minutes left. You had a fucking lucky ass play. I hate showboating. I really do. Showboating is just fucking garbage. It really is. And I'm talking about in the game and in professional sports and real life. I hate showboating. Oh, look at me. I took a fucking oddly shaped ball and I ran it over a white line. Hooray. Yeah, great. You get paid millions of fucking dollars to do it. Score your goddamn touchdown. Hand the ball off to the referee and go back to the sidelines, jerk off. You didn't fucking cure cancer or cure AIDS or stop a world war. Okay? Stop your showboating shit. And the same thing with this game. Ooh, my virtual character scored. Let me fucking dive on you and showboat, you jackass. I hate showboating. I can't stand it. It's just classless fucking garbage. I gotta put a drive together here, though. Thing that sucks too is I have to score a touchdown. He was in a different position where he could, you know, tie the game and it'd been okay. I'm at the point where I have to score a touchdown. Oh man, come on, T.Y., outrun that. If he would outrun that, I'd be scooting up the sideline right now. Can't believe I fucking threw that pick right back to him. There, that's what I was looking for, T.Y. Good job. And I got out of bounds, saved myself a timeout. Come on, Ozzie, break that tackle. I love how the old school players, they have the old school helmets on too. It looks funny. If I'm seeing that correctly. Look like Ozzie Newsome had a funny helmet on. Hey, if he's going to keep giving me those routes, man, I'll take him all day long. Not gonna hurt my feelings. That stupid Josh Norman, he's garbage. Oh God, is he bad. That's the biggest mistake fucking contract the Redskins, one of the I shouldn't say the biggest because they've signed some bad players, man. Or spent some stupid money on garbage players. But that one was definitely a huge mistake. He's just so overrated, it's not even funny. I mean, Dez Bryant destroyed him. I could have thrown it to B too, but I'm trying to be a little careful here. I got plenty of time. I still got two timeouts. But he loves to give me these freaking routes. See, this is what sucks though, because the game's still not over. He's got all three timeouts and he's got 30 seconds left. And one bomb to Moss. And he's in field goal range. this game flipped when I threw the ball back to him. If I would have been able to score on that drive, I would have been able to seal this game, and I fucked up. So now I got to be really careful here. I did not want to get mossed. That's good. That took off 7 seconds. Ooh, that was smart. But that still took off 6 seconds. If he wants to take the underneath stuff, I'll give it to him. I just do not want to get mossed. Get him down. Ah, he got out of bounds. Give me that. Whew, man, this is dodgy. Beautiful. Well, actually, I wish he would have caught that. No, never mind. It's good that he dropped it. Well, I don't know what the hell that was. I iced him. Let's see if he knows how to handle the ice. No good. Wide left. Boy, I'll tell you, it wasn't easy, man. And I almost fucking gave it up. I almost gave it up. But that was that's where the icing came into play. I apologize for the video running long. I hope you guys liked it. I'm going to try and post more this weekend or later during the week. In the meantime, like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you next time. Later.